Good morning, Internet. It's 8:30 in the morning, and we have just started our day. Our travel partners for the day is, or for the entire trip, is actually Serengeti Smile. We did quite a bit of research before selecting the safari partner, and let's see how it goes with them. This is the Gypsy for the next 12 days of our safari. It seems pretty nice. So today we will be traveling from Arusha to Southern Serengeti. We will be going through somewhere like Lake Maniara. We will be crossing. We will be taking a right turn from the crossing near Tarangire, and the entire trip will take us around 5 hours of drive. The road conditions seems pretty nice. No potholes seen so far, so it's pretty good actually. And the soil is absolutely red, as you can see. After almost 3.5 hours, we have reached Gorongoro Gate, and we are now entering the main national park area. The landscape kind of changed abruptly from dry to lush green, and it already seems pretty nice. As we are entering, we can see other gypsies coming out. Maybe they have just completed their safari. I'm really excited now, and hope that it will be a great adventure for the next 12 days. And the first sightings of the baboons. There are plenty out of here, all the baboons, and when we also came here the last time, we could also see them, and there's always a word of caution that you should keep your gypsies closed and do not leave it open, because baboons can often go inside for search of food, and then it's not a good situation anyways. Over here we have to get our permits checked, and also we will take a very short break. Well, all the permit checks are done. Now, one last final check before we are allowed inside the national park. Well, people are very friendly over here, and everybody seems to know each other, which is nice. And now we have entered the national park, no more favorites from here. Let's have a short intro of Gorongoro from our guide.
Area where the Maasai people and the one animal live together in a harmony way. So in that case, Gorongoro is a mountain. It erupted 2.5 million years past, and it is a type of biggest caldera. It's called caldera, and whereby the erupting purpose is not a small one, it's a big one. We call it in the geographical language bombardment. It's did the bombardment, it formed the caldera. The size of the caldera is at 300 kilometers in the floor of the crater. In that case, Ngorongoro is unique, the part of the UNESCO. Why? Because of the old animal found here with the Maasai people who live in the culture. Viewpoint whereby we look down all the viewpoint of the Ngorongoro and all the caldera and all animals there. The size of the kilometer here is 300 kilometers square and all the animal, 25,000 animals found in the crater.
It's a lovely little viewpoint for the Ngorongoro crater. Few people seems interested in something that's walking on the floor of the crater. Ah, there are a few rhinos, they're saying, but it's quite far off. Actually very far off from here. You can barely see it even from here. Finally, we have actually spotted the rhinos. Not this side, but on the right hand side, on the floor of the crater. But they are very small. They cannot be captured, or I can't capture them in the video. It's very far off. I need my lenses for that. It's very far off. The first glimpse of the zebras. It's just beside the dog and don't even seem to mind the gypsies.
They
seem very accustomed with the gypsies. And the zebras, the huts that you can see are the Maasai villages. There are a number of Maasai villages actually on this part of the land. On the left hand side of Ngorongoro crater, the Maasai villages we can see all the way from here till we reach southern Serengeti. But till the time we come down from this volcano, there are Maasai villages all over, scattered though, but there are a number of them. See. As we continued, we just saw some of the wildebeest. It's a small herd of wildebeest. Usually wildebeests are in a herd of thousands that we can see, but over here it's not that many, but I'm sure we will find a lot more wildebeest herd when we go in. We can also see some small wildebeest cubs. They are a few days to few weeks old, as I am told. One of the main reasons we came to Serengeti this time is to also see the calvings. Fingers crossed, hope we can see some when we go in. Now the giraffes. It's been only around half an hour to 1 hour we entered and we have already seen so many games. We have now came down from the Ngorongoro and now we are on on the way to Southern Serengeti. So this is more of a flat land now, not the mountain that we were in the Porongoro crater. Just took a small break in this museum. It's an archaeological museum. That's a nice sculpture, very nice. Thank you. That's a go shack. We just came across the road. It's just sitting beside the road. Ostriches, they're actually quite far off, not that close, but it's magnificent. This is the main Serengeti gate. From here, the Southern Serengeti and Central Serengeti get divided. We took the left turn from the gate and we are going to the Southern Serengeti now. The real game has now started. We have managed to now take out the roof of the gypsy, so there will be a bit more noise. And we are also going a bit slow now, enjoying the game. There are thousands and thousands of zebras and wildebeest all across, and we have also started to see the gazelles. Backdrop, you can see the Porongoro from where we just drove. What an amazing place it is. Just came across this jackal's den. Our driver was very smart in spotting this jackal's den. And the moment we came over here, they're walking away from the den. So there is a small cub, and the hole that you can see in front of the cub is the den. So well hidden, so well hidden. And there it goes. We have now entered the main region of the Southern Serengeti, and yeah, on the road you can see the wildebeest and the zebras crossing. There's a small water body on the right hand side, so they're going there for some drink. It's almost 3 o'clock now. We have another 1.5 to 2 hours of game left for the day. It's a very small water body, but enough for the wildebeest and the zebras to quench their thirst a bit. Zebras usually take protection from the herd of the wildebeest because of the sheer numbers. Now also there is a small water hole here that the giraffe is bending down. It seems to be very difficult for him to actually bend down and drink that. It seems to be a safe place. It's quite a bit of bend, I have to say. And now we met the first herd of elephants. There is a very tiny one in the herd. I don't know whether you can spot it or not. It's yeah, there it is now. Much clearer view. It's very tiny, not even a month old it seems. It's almost 4:30 now, and it's almost time that we have to go to our tent. Just managed to spot our first lion and the lioness. What a sight. We are told that this is not far away from our tent. It's not even a kilometer. Wow. It has a collar, so it's been tracked, but of course it is wild, so it's as wild as it can get. Both of them seem to laze around a lot, so yeah. They're magnificent, isn't it? I think we have to soon leave them and head for accommodation. It's already getting dark. Almost 5:30, and we have to reach the accommodation latest by 6. Peaceful nap. Okay, now we have finally reached our accommodation. This tenting site is called Serengeti Heritage Camp. These are all tented accommodation, and of course no fencing. They were helpful in carrying our suitcases and putting it in the tent. We of course chose the last tent so that we can be in the nature as much as possible without any disturbance. So over here we will be staying for the next 3 days. Sun is just sitting behind the tent. We had our dinner and probably we'll just wait here for a while beside the bonfire, enjoy it a bit before we call it a day and we're ready for tomorrow.